हाय फ्रेंड्स, नौकरी सीरीज कैरियर वेलकम एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वायरल टॉपिक, दैट इज न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी। न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 2020, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज In coming years, new education policy is going to be implemented in our education system. Our education system is going to be totally changed by the means of mode of teaching, by the means of content, syllabus, etc. First of all, going into deep about new education policy 2020, let we have a little bit glimpse over what is the running structure of our education system, that means academic structure of our education system up to plus two level. Let's see here. See, this is the present plus two academic structure running in our system. We have primary school, middle school and higher school. In primary school we have a standard 1 to 5th, in middle school a standard 6 to 8, and in high school from 9th to 12th. And there are here, you see, this is the primary from 1st to, this is the 6th standard to 8th standard, and from 9th standard to plus 2 we have high school. In some cases we also see that the school is starting from 6 to plus 2, that also comes under high school. In private schools we have kids play school, where child of an age 3 to 5 years get admission. This is in private nature, not in government nature, and this is the government structure. In government structure we know that at 10th there is a board, 10th board, which is conducted, organized by either a state or central. Similarly, at plus 2, there is a plus 2 board organized by central or state. After passing the board, 10th board, students get promoted in the 11th class. And similarly, after passing plus 2 board, students are become eligible to get admission in bachelor's degree. This is the present plus 2 academic structure. And now we are going to discuss the academic structure in new education policy 2020. Let's see. This is new plus 2 academic structure. This new plus 2 academic structure has been divided into 4 parts. First part is foundation, second part is preparatory, third one is middle, and the last one is secondary stage. This foundation stage is of 5 years program, preparatory will be of 3 years program, middle stage will be of 3 years program, and the last secondary stage will be of 4 years program. Now see, in foundation stage, this has been divided again into 2 parts. One is pre-primary, this is pre-primary. Where child at an age of 3 years get admitted. That means between the age of 3 to 6 years, child will be under the guidelines of a Anganwadi Kendra. After this, the child will be promoted to class 1 and 2. That comes in the primary stage of foundation. In the pre-primary, the children will be provided play-based teaching. Play-based teaching. Fully enjoyable. And in the class 1 and 2, which is 2 years program, in which children will study about numerics, an alphabet. Between the age of 8 to 11 years, in the preparatory stage, that comes, that includes class 3 to 5 standard, in which students will be given some textbooks, introduction of textbook. As we know that preparatory is a 3 years program. In the middle stage, that means class starts from 6 to 8, and the ages will be between 11 to 14 years. Our students will have to go more of preparatory study books, and there also will be the introduction of paper subjects like science, social science, humanities, maths, etc. This will be completed in 3 years program in the middle stage, and in the final stage, that means starting standard 9 to 12, which also has been divided in two parts, one from 9 to 10 and second one from 11 to 12. In this secondary stage, students will be provided more and more and deeper knowledge of the papers. There will be flexibility in selection of the papers as per the choice of students in the secondary. And also, there will be no any certain board which is in present structure, but there will be assessment of the students at each level, at 10th level as well as at plus 2 level. That means, what is the assessment of the students? Whether the students are growing or not, how can we judge? How can it be assessed? So, the teachers will assess truly the students, and if there are any have problems, they will again provided best and best teaching. Now we will see what is the difference between the running structure and this new plus 2 academic structure. Here we are seeing that students at an age of 3 years are introducing in the education, which is not in the present or running structure of education system. And the most important is this, there is a flexibility in education system. What is the burden of examination? In present scenario, there is no such burden. But the assessment is done by the well-trained teachers in order to make more and more growth in the students. And the most important of this structure, 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, is that students who are belonging to rural and remote areas, what is his or her mother language? Or Tang language, in that language, the textbooks will be made available to students till foundation. It means that till foundation, students will be guided by the means of his/her own language, means mother language. As we all know that 3 to 6 years is a very, very important age, in duration of which, in which students grow up their skills, their thinking ability also. So it is considered that in the mother language, if they are taught, they will be catch the syllables very easily. They will understand the things are happening and what the teachers want to tell, they will easily get. Now in the preparatory, middle or secondary stage, there is flexibility. Flexibility in the means that if one is studying biology, they can also study chemistry, math. All you can see, that means there is a flexibility in education system. That means students are given much more flexibility to opt any subject. More details we will do in the next video. Thank you.